Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can manage versions of process which are created in Process Builder. Before starting, if you want to watch Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So here you will see various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages are available, so you can follow them. So you can search Process Builder in setup, then you can click on new to create new Process Builder. So let's say I'm creating a process on account, right? And this process will start when a record changes. I'm saving this. So first of all, you need to select the object on which you are going to create a process. So if you are creating multiple process, then this warning message will be displayed, like account already has active record change processes. So best practice is that you have to implement only one process on one object, but for demonstration purpose, I am creating one more so that we can see how we can manage the versions of processes. So I chose account as object, then criteria, I'm choosing no criteria, just execute the action, so it will be executed always. Then for action, I am choosing email alert, send emails, and from here so there is no alert on contact, so let me choose some other thing. Let's update a record. So I'm giving action name as update account. Record type will be the record that started the process, and here let's say I'm changing account source as web and click on save. Right, so this way I created this process. So as soon as I activate it, so its first version will be created. Right, now I'm going to click on view all processes. So here you can see process on account is available, and here its version one is available, which is active, and last modified date is available. Now if I again open this version one, now if I want to change something in this version, so I need to click on clone. And here you can see it is asking for two options: save, clone as version of current process or a new process. So right now I'm selecting version of current process. So you will see under a process on account name, another version will be created. So let's say I am changing this field here. So I'm removing account source and I'm choosing any other field, let's say active, no, and I'm clicking on save. So this way I modified the process, and again I am activating it. So now you can see version 2 is created and last modified date is available, and this version 2 is active. And whenever you activate a newer version, then the older version will be deactivated automatically, and you can also delete that deactivated version. Now, if you want to open version one, you need to click here. If you want to open version two, you need to click here. And if you again click on clone, so there will be two options. Either you can create new version or you can create new process, right? So let's say I am opening this version two, clicking on clone, and I am clicking here on new process. So as you click on new process, so you need to provide a process name as well. So I'm giving name as process on account 2, right? And clicking on save, clicking on activate. Now I'm going to view all processes. So here you can see this process is having two versions, and this is the new process which is having only one version. So this way, you can manage your versions while implementing processes through process builder. So this is very important. And remember one thing also, like if you referenced any field in a particular version and you want to delete that field or any other component like email alert or anything else that is referenced in a particular version. So if you don't delete the version, then you won't be able to delete that field or email alert or any other thing. So first you need to delete the version where you have referenced certain things, and then you can delete those things. So remember that we have various versions. So sometimes it happens like you are going to delete a particular field and it is referenced in a various versions of a process and you are not able to delete that. So in that case, you need to open a process. You need to check all its versions where that field or other component is referenced. Then you need to delete those all versions, and then only you can be able to delete that field or other components. So for that purpose, these version controlling is also important. So I hope you understood how we can manage versions and processes. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube, and you can follow various playlists related to computer programming. So thank you for watching this video.